Of course, you know, you always have the thought of, is this going to work? You're sending a spacecraft millions and millions of miles away. It's mind-boggling, the technology that's required to pull that off.
And NASA did pull it off with the launch of an unprecedented mission to the outskirts of our solar system. NASA's Cassini spacecraft arrived in Florida on April 21st, 1997, to begin months of processing before its launch in October to the distant planet Saturn. Cassini's mission was daring: go into orbit around the ring planet, send the most detailed readings and best pictures ever taken back to Earth, deploy a probe to the moon Titan, survey Saturn's other dozens of moons, and dive between the rings.
The size of it was impressive. To consider the size and how far it was going, and the fact that it included a probe, that was impressive to me.
But before it could set new landmarks for science in space, Cassini had to make it safely off Earth, riding atop an Air Force Titan IV-B rocket. Going to Saturn, where the sun is too distant to feed solar panels enough energy for the spacecraft, Cassini would rely instead on a plutonium-fueled generator called an RTG.
You had these RTG, or nuclear sources, that you were going to mount up to the bottom. So the problem of maintaining everything cool with these, you know, nuclear heaters, seeing that all come together for me was just eye-opening, and it was a whole new ball game.
Launch day would be the major test of the team that made Cassini ready for space.
When it came down to October 15th, 1997, and that thing was launched, everybody breathed a sigh of relief and just exhaled and relished in it.
The team had worked for years on it, and when it all came off, it was just very, very satisfying that, you know, all these years of effort was a success, and we got it off the ground, and it's on its way to Saturn.